Welcome to the Fit Small Business Xero training course. In this lesson, we're going to cover how to set up sales tax rates in Xero. To follow along with me, log into your Xero account now or click the link below this video for a free 30-day trial of Xero. You can also click this link to access our full Xero course and other helpful resources. Let's get started. As a business owner, you are responsible for keeping track of, reporting, and paying a number of different taxes. If you sell products and services that are taxable, then you are required to charge sales tax to your customers and send the sales tax payment along with the appropriate documents to your state tax authority by the deadline. Most small businesses are on a monthly, quarterly, or annual payment cycle. One of the many benefits of using Xero is that it has everything that you need to stay on top of sales tax. You can use the sales tax lookup feature, keep track of the sales tax you collect from customers, and file and pay your sales taxes all from within Xero. We will use our fictitious company, Acme Web Pros Plus, to cover step-by-step how to set up your sales tax rates in Xero. From the settings menu, we're going to go ahead and navigate over to general settings and scroll down. Right below the organization section, you'll see tax rates here on the left. Go ahead and click on that. So here's some helpful hints here at the top on getting started with tax rates. So to set up a new sales tax rate, as you can see, we've got six rates already set up. So we'll click the edit button here, which will expand so we can see the details of what tax rates are currently in place. And then to set up a new tax rate, you want to go ahead and click the new tax rate button here. As you can see, there are a few fields that we need to complete in this screen. Starting with the tax rate display name. In this field, we want to include the name of the tax as you would like it to appear on invoices, purchase orders, and reports. Tax components. If the sales tax includes multiple components, so for example, if you have a city tax and a state tax component, then you want to add each component along with the tax rate for each one. So in our example, we'll go ahead and set up a city tax. And we'll do that, 7%. And then we'll go ahead and add a state tax component as well. And that'll be at 2% here. So as you notice, what Xero will do, we'll go ahead and combine each tax component to get the total tax rate that will be applied to all transactions that are subject to this tax rate. So once you are done, you can go ahead and click Save. And our new sales tax rate is right here, Orange County sales tax. You may have a situation where you need to come in and make changes to a sales tax rate. You can do that at any time by simply clicking on the sales tax rate that you want to make changes to. And once the window opens up, you can make the necessary changes and then just make sure that you save them. You may also encounter a situation where you need to delete a tax rate. To do that, from this screen, you would just put a check mark next to the tax rate. Notice here it says one item selected, and we've got our delete button here. And so you could just click delete and proceed to delete the tax rate. There are a few tax rates that have been automatically created by Xero that you are not able to delete. If the tax rate has a padlock to the left of it, like these do, you are not able to delete or make any changes to these tax rates. These are required to stay set up in Xero. One of the things that sets Xero apart from its competitors is the sales tax lookup feature. If you sell products and services to customers who are located in a different tax jurisdiction, you can use this lookup sales tax feature to find the correct sales tax rate that you need to charge. Xero's sales tax lookup feature, once turned on, adds an option to the sales tax column of an invoice that allows you to look up the sales tax rate based on your customer's address. By using the sales tax lookup feature in Xero, you can avoid overcharging or undercharging your customers for sales tax. If you undercharge your customers, you will be on the hook to make up the difference when it's time to remit payment to the tax authority. This can come back to haunt you if you ever have to undergo a sales tax audit. To turn on the sales tax lookup feature, here is the sales tax lookup. We'll go ahead and click edit. And the feature here, if it's not turned on, the check mark would not be here. So this feature has been turned on. In this field, you want to go ahead and enter your physical address for your business. As indicated here, this is where you ship products from. So it may not necessarily be your office, it may actually be the address of your warehouse if you ship products. You also want to be able to indicate the states where your business is registered to collect sales tax in this field as well. You want to be sure to click the terms of use that you've read and agreed to the terms of use for the sales tax lookup feature. This feature is provided by Xero's tax partner, Avalara. So once that feature is turned on and saved, you are able to create an invoice that will allow you to look up the sales tax rate. So let's see how this would work. All right, let's hop on over to create an invoice so that we can see how the sales tax lookup feature would work. We'll select a customer here. And an item. So notice under the tax rate column, if you click the drop down, you have a list of all of the sales tax rates that have been created in Xero, and we've also got this handy dandy lookup rate option. And so that option would not be there if we had not turned on the lookup feature. So you select that option, and then the sales tax rate will be looked up based on the address information on file for your customer. So notice it selected the CA tax 8.5% rate. And so that's how that would work for the lookup feature. All right, let's talk about sales tax reporting. There are two reports that you can run to review your sales tax transactions in Xero: the sales tax summary report and the sales tax audit report. So to run the sales tax summary report, we want to go ahead and go over to the report section, and we'll select all reports. And right below the tax group, we've got our sales tax report. Go ahead and select a date range. So we'll run this report for January 1st through March 31st and update it. So notice that we've got three options right below the date range. You can run this report to show it by tax rate. The default is to show it by tax component. And then finally, you can run this report to show it by account type. So here's our sales tax summary report for Acme Web Pros Plus for the time period January 1st through March 31st, 2017. And so what you'll notice here is here's our taxes by tax component, since that's the option that we chose. At the bottom of this report, you will notice that you can print the report or export it to Excel, PDF, or Google Sheets. Let's talk about our sales tax audit report. So right next to sales tax summary, we've got our sales tax audit report. Go ahead and click on that. The sales tax audit report shows the sales tax calculated for each transaction for the period by sales tax rate. So this report was run for the same exact time period as the sales tax summary report. And as you can see, it is categorized by the sales tax rate. Similar to the sales tax summary report, you can print this report or you can export it to Excel, PDF, or Google Sheets. Now let's talk about how do you prepare and file sales taxes in Xero. So we'll go ahead and stay here on the sales tax summary report. And we, as we discussed earlier, the sales tax information that you track in Xero can be used to prepare and file your sales taxes. In order to file your sales taxes, you must set up an account with Xero's sales tax partner, Avalara. Once your Avalara account is set up, you can easily import your sales tax data from Xero to Avalara and then use that information to run sales tax reports in Avalara to help you file and pay your sales tax. So the first thing that you must do is actually set up an account with Avalara. Setting up an account with Avalara is absolutely free. And to do that, we're just going to scroll down to the bottom of this report and click this button that says File Online. This note here is just letting you know that you can prepare and file your sales tax returns online by signing up with Avalara. And as I mentioned, this account is absolutely free. You'll be able to import your sales data and run reports that sort state and jurisdiction taxes to help file your returns. Note that there is a cost to file directly to a tax department using Avalara. So there's no charge to use Avalara, but there is a charge to actually file your taxes through Avalara. So we'll go ahead and click the continue button. This will go ahead and take us to the Avalara website. On this site, you want to go ahead and select the For Merchants button here. And then it's going to take you to a screen where you just need to follow the on-screen instructions to set up your free Avalara account. That wraps up the lesson on how to set up sales tax rates in Xero. To access our full Xero course or any of the other lessons in this series, click this link. You can also find a link below this video for a free 30-day trial of Xero. If you would like to leave a comment, or if you have feedback about this course, please leave it below. Also, don't forget to subscribe.